I'm with Rasha Salsa from Meet Palestine. Now, Rasha, what is Meet Palestine?
Meet Palestine is a Palestinian initiative that we started lately here in Palestine, Bethlehem. It's an initiative that we started to introduce the Palestinian products made by Palestinians here in Palestine to the world outside. Overseas. We gather products and arts and food, music, literature, books from different people, and we try to market them and to make them reach more people overseas.
So is this a new initiative, and why did you start it?
Yes, it's a new initiative. I think there are many factors why we started it. I think it started after COVID or during COVID, let's say, to create more opportunities for businesses and individuals, small businesses and individuals who are losing their businesses during this difficult time. So I think this is the thing that made us more, or urged us more to start with it. But the other idea about Meet Palestine, which is very, very essential, is that we thought that there should be another way of producing ourselves as Palestinians to the world. So we thought we should maybe look at other options of how to introduce our culture, our heritage, our human side, our creativity, our talents, our beautiful minds all together to the people out there. So we thought we should start by gathering the talents and the creativity that we have in our people and show it to people outside.
Are all your products made here in Palestine?
Yes, all of our products are made here in Palestine and are designed by Palestinians and made by Palestinians. We even work with designers who make artistic items, and we work with craftsmen, we work with artists as well. We work with the food producers, we work with the carvers.
Do you also have products that have been made by disabled people?
Yes, we do. We work with societies that do the felt products, like for example, Ma'an al-Haya here in Bethlehem. They do felt products and felt items that are created by people with disabilities, so to make them more involved and to make them more giving and make life a little bit more cheerful for them.
So you're helping them, and they're helping bringing dignity,
yes,
into Palestinian disabilities.
Exactly. We're helping them, and they're helping bringing dignity to those people and to help them be more progressive in their lives.
Does Palestine make great products, and what sort of things do they make?
We make all types of products that you might think of. Food, for example, olive oil, wine, beer, za'atar, thyme. That's one category. If you go and look at like our olive wood collection, carvers, we've been carvers for so long. People of Bethlehem, in particular Christians of Bethlehem, have been doing this for ages. And it's a tradition that keeps moving from one family, from like the grandfather to the father and then to the son. So many families in the area here do the olive wood carvings. We have designers who design some types of jewelry, olive wood jewelry, silver, even brass with the gold-plated jewelry. They do the designs, that they create the designs, and then they make them. We have the embroidery as well. Women from Palestine have always been known for doing the nicest embroidery that is also related. Each town has its own products or its own designs of embroidery. We have arts as well. On the website also, we have an online gallery where we tend to display artistic pieces done by artists, Palestinian artists from the area. Ceramics as well. We do ceramics. We've been working with different sources for who do ceramics. They do actually paint them. They make the ceramics and they paint on the ceramics as well by hand. Also, we have the Dead Sea products and the soaps, Nablus soaps in particular, which is made of olive oil, and it's very, very, very healthy, very good for the skin, different types of skin. And we have the Dead Sea products as well.
Are some of these products regional? So different cities make a different product?
Yes, most of the products are original actually, and some of them are made by designers who have created this item or these items, and they are the only ones who can produce them because it's their creation. Also, like if you look at it from another angle, like for example, the area of Bethlehem has always been known for the olive wood carvings, whereas if you go to Nablus, The main thing that is very well known in Mablus is the soap, the olive oil soap. So the embroideries, for example, if you go to any town, they have their own drawings, they have their own embroideries, patterns. That is very much related to their country, to their city, or to their heritage in that particular city. Hebron is very famous also for ceramics, and also they do the glass, the wine glass, which is very, very unique and can only be found over there in Hebron. The ceramics also, what we do as well, we do ceramics from other towns where they come up with original and more modern styles of drawing on ceramics, so it's a little bit spreading as well. Also, some of our products is olive oil. Olive oil, we work with the societies that bring the olive from the farmers, and they press it and they pack it and they leave it. And then afterwards, they market it and sell it. So we are also working with those people. We have organic olive oil as well that is being pressed and sold through Meat Palestine.
Has this year been difficult for crafts makers because of COVID? There's no tourists, so there's no able to sell here in the land.
Yes, definitely COVID has been shutting the doors for many people who are, especially like the small businesses and the people, the individuals who have been working in the tourism field. They don't necessarily have to be working in the tourism field directly, but they have been depending on tourists who would come and to buy their products and their creations as well. So they have been having no one coming or no one considering their pieces for a long time already, with not a single bit of income at all.
Your website is basically a lifeline for some people.
Yes, it is actually. Yes, it is. And we're aiming at even making it more and more spread to be able to help and to support more people who have been struggling for a while now.
Now, Christmas is coming soon. Do you sell Christmas products like Christmas nativities? Are they very popular, and Christmas decorations and ornaments?
Yes, actually. We have many pieces that are very much related to Christmas. We have lots of Christmas nativities, Olivewood nativities, felt nativities. We have lots of Olivewood ornaments. We also have a very unique nativity this year. That is the wall nativity, which just describes the situation at the moment, which is how the wise men are just unable to reach baby Jesus because of the wall that has just stood up between them. So that's also a very popular nativity that we are selling on our website, and it's been going quite well, selling quite well actually.
So has your website been very, very important this year for people here living in the land?
Yes, I think so. Yani, at least it's one step forward to handling the situation and to giving more hope to many people who live here and to try to get things back on track, let's say, even if it was just less, just a bit at the moment.
Are you adding more product to the website?
We are adding more products almost every week. We put more stuff on the website very frequently. And after we even launched the website, we started getting people. At the beginning, we were contacting people to show us their products. At the moment, people, Palestinians who are living in the area here, they have been contacting us and asking us to consider their products to add to the website and to market on our website as well. So that's a good sign, I think.
So product makers are actually getting excited about your website?
Yes, definitely. Yes, yes. The product makers are very excited about adding, about putting their products on our website. It's just, as I said, it's just a step forward into making life a little bit easier for people and into making life a step forward, closer to getting back to normal life.
Yeah. Is there any hope in Bethlehem at the moment because of the virus? We've got no tourists coming in, so again, product makers are still not able to sell their products to tourists. So is there hope in Bethlehem at the moment?
At the moment, I think marketing online is the only way to support these people and to give them a little bit of hope. Otherwise, like, nobody's coming. The hotels are closed. Nobody, like, these people mainly sell these products to tourists and to people from other countries. So it's like the local sales are very, very minimum. So they depend mainly on tourists and people from outside the country to sell their products. So at the moment, no hope except to market online and to sell online for those people. We hope that the next year things will just be different and then life can start to go back to normal with the COVID vaccine and stuff like that. But even then, we don't think that we will stop our work. I think we'll just even continue and reach more people with our website. Whoever cannot come and visit us, we can reach them and we can make them meet us, and we meet them through our work.
Which countries do you export to?
We do export to everywhere in the world, worldwide. So far, we've been having lots of orders, actually, from the UK and the USA. These are the main two countries that have been doing orders so far, individually, most of them. But, like, we are open to sell worldwide.
Is it easy getting product out from Bethlehem to the world?
It's not easy, but it's not too complicated. It's under control. Like, we usually do that through sending them through the Israeli shipping companies. Yes, yeah. DHL and EMS. These are the two main channels that we use, mostly EMS.
So what's your hope for the future?
We hope for the future as everybody else, like for things to improve a little bit, for people to get back to their lives, for people to start to enjoy the blessings that they have a little bit more, and to be able to get going again to normal and to the usual life that we used to have before this. Also, the other thing that I think Meet Palestine, we hope for to achieve through Meet Palestine, in addition to supporting our people here, it's to support or to highlight the idea of looking at us as people of Palestine, as people of heritage, as people of culture, as people of ambition and creative minds as well. So this is the other point that we look for through Meet Palestine, to introduce ourselves as Palestinians, as people of open minds and beautiful minds as well.
And particularly on Facebook, when people go to your Facebook page, they can actually see videos of the people who are making the product as well, can't they?
Yes, we have the website and we have a Facebook page and we have a page on Instagram, or an account on Instagram as well. What we do there is, like, we have one section that is called Meet Our Partners at Meet Palestine, where we invite our partners, we go and we film them and we do videos about their work. We ask them to talk a little bit about what they do, what inspirations they have, and the bits about the products themselves. So this way people get to meet our people, which is very important, which is like the core of our initiative, our business here.
So what's your website and what's your Facebook page?
Okay, the website is www.meetpalestine.com, and Facebook can find us on Meet Palestine, and the same the Instagram, it's meet.palestine. So yeah, you can follow any of these or check any of these, and you'll find lots of videos, lots of products, lots of pieces. Even the photographs that we take, we try to put the items into context and to put them in houses and places where you can really see how the item would look like here and there.
Okay, Rasha, thank you very much.
You are welcome. Thank you for your interest in our work.